Good day everyone, let us now discuss geometric sequences and series. So in this video, we will start by defining the geometric sequence and then in the latter part, you will try to derive a formula for the nth term of a geometric sequence. Okay, to start with the definition, a geometric sequence is an ordered list of numbers. Okay, an ordered list of numbers in which each term after the first is found by multiplying the previous one by a fixed non-zero number called the common ratio. Okay, so based on the definition, what can we say about the difference between an arithmetic sequence and a geometric sequence? Now, if we recall, in the arithmetic sequence, we add a particular constant, right, to each previous term. Now, in the geometric sequence, we multiply that constant and we call that the common ratio R. Okay, so let's try it. Let's try to see an example here. Let's try to examine this. So the second term is 6. So what did we multiply 3 to get 6? That would be 2, right? So again, we multiply 2 to 6, we get 12. And then multiply 2 again, 24. Multiply 2, 48, and so on. So this is a geometric sequence with an R, a common ratio of 2. Okay? Now, the common ratio can also be, let's say, 1 half. So, let's say, for example, we have here 10. Let's say our first term is 10. And if our R... If R is equal to 1 half, then you'll get the second term will be 5, right? And then what? 5 divided by 2, that's 2.5. So 2.5 divided by 2, that would be 1.25. And so on and so forth. Okay? So that's the if R is 1 half. So now let's try to come up with a formula to getting the nth term of a particular geometric sequence. So let's try to observe this example right here. So if we write this generally, we have here RA1 is equal to 3, right? So we have here A1, then our second term will be A1, right? A1 multiplied by R, right? A1 is 3, R is 2. So we get 6. So in the next term, 12, we can get that by multiplying A1 again by R squared. So we have 3 times R squared, 2 squared is 4, we get 12, right? So let's proceed. Let's proceed to the next ones. We have here A1, R cubed, right? That's 3 times, what's 2 cubed? That's 8, so we get 24. So we see a pattern right here. So we have here A1, R raised to 4, so on. So as you can see, so this is our first term, second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term. So we can say that to get An, we just multiply A1 by R raised to N minus 1. Now, why did we use N minus 1? So if we take a look at the pattern here, on the fifth, to get the fifth term, you multiply A1 by R raised to 4, right? Get there? So 4 is 5 minus 1, in case you're going to get the fifth term, okay? So this is our formula for that. So it's for the nth term of a particular geometric sequence. So if you have A1, if you have your A1 and then you want to find let's say the 100th term or whatever position that you want to find, and then you can find it using this formula. Okay, so we will do some examples in the next video. So thank you for watching this video and I will see you in the next one.